DP with the GM on WRTI-FM. Another Eve, another great round of great music. For openers, let's start out with the sermon this evening, James Oscar Smith. This, of course, a classic. Smith, credited with starting it all around in the middle 1950s, and he was so good at it, he sort of changed the face of the jazz organ. He met Wild Bill Davis, who was a very popular organist. Davis opened new vistas for him. The B3 organ is a very complex instrument. He was able to handle it and do with it what nobody else heretofore has done.
During the time, organ was big. I think it was big because you could have four pieces in your club and it sounded like you had a big orchestra in your club.
He's going for this free sound that's a drone almost, but he had great modern conception of harmony. You're going for like an emotional, spiritual thing that's more simple and direct.
He improved on the bass line, and also his attack was different. And he did young and exciting things that other people weren't doing.
Classic in all respects, the sermon played by Jimmy Smith. In just a little bit, we'll hear from Miss Shirley Scott and spouse Stanley Turrentine from this compilation titled The Best of Shirley Scott. How about Soul Shoutin'? She did it so naturally, and she just had a nice, easy, loping style. She married, of course, Stanley Turrentine. They made a lot of great music together.
She didn't play that powerful thing that Jimmy did. Shirley, she had that educational thing, and she knew how to back somebody. She knew how to push them. That's really what an organist was, is to back people and also then do your own thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me bring her out right now. Let's give her a warm San Francisco welcome.
Yes, yes, yes.
Miss Shirley Scott. Shirley Scott.
She was a very talented young woman. Well, she started out with piano and trumpet. And then later in her career, she hitched on to the B3 and made quite a name for herself. In fact, she became known as the Queen of the Organ.
She was a nurturer, and she had a passion and compassion for making sure that the essentials of what she thought about jazz, you know, melody, swing, you know, rhythm, and joy was always part of the music. I mean, the way she could build a solo was unbelievable.
When one talks of organists in particular, or organists in general, in the first five, there must be the names Charles Earland mentioned. He was one of the best. Here we have an LP titled Blacktop, and he has some mighty folk on there with him. One of his most famous renditions of this particular tune, I Love You More Today Than Yesterday.
He was something like Groove Holmes. They had such a jovial type of mood when they played. And they looked like they were happy doing what they did, which automatically made the people feel happy. It was a happy groove, and he was known for that.
That song pretty much exemplifies the bop. That's a good example of Philadelphia's organ music. If you play that, everyone's gonna dance in the club.
A lot of times when you hear an organ player play a song, any organ player, it's just that song being interpreted on an organ, you know? But some songs that you hear an organ player play, the organ actually just changes the whole concept of the song. Charles Earland kind of like stretched it out, took a little R&B and put it in there, you know, took a little blues and put it in there. Comes through the fingertips right on out to you. You know, that's where it goes. Yeah.